So today or tomorrow we will be part of public life. So while we are allowed to deal with life of crores of people, so our personality, our thinking, our thought process should be relatively better than the rest of the people. We are here to understand who we are.
So we'll see how governance will be transformed to good governance and good governance to ethical governance. So we'll see public administration, governance to good governance to ethical governance, and we'll come to know about the probity in governance. So my morality is personal thing. My personal belief and will allow me to interact with others. So zaruri nahi hamari value hamesha sahi ho, but my morality will allow me to interact with you. So morality is about our own belief system. Kuch log janwaron ko maarna khana acha samajhte hain, their value is different, and kuch log nahi samajhte, unki value different hai. So morality is about our belief system. So ethics is systematic scientific critical analysis of morality. So what is ethics? Is systematic scientific and critical analysis of morality. To isliye morality public administration mein nahi dekhte hain, we talk about ethics in public administration. So we'll see public administration. So people who are mature are called public. Maturity is a relative phenomena. Mother nahi consider kar rahi hai, wo mature hai, mother ke liye abhi mature nahi hai. So public people se alag hai. Public means mature people. And administration alag hai rules se. I rule you means I dominate you. Our parents rule us. That doesn't mean the ruler will always be experienced. That they are not expert. Rulers are not expert. For example, Ashoka. Sara kar raha hai, lekin wo expert nahi tha. Judiciary bhi dekh raha hai, executive, legislative. मदर आपको सर्व करिए, सपोज आप बीमार हो, लेकिन आप किसके पास जाओगे? एक्सपर्ट के पास जाओगे. लेकिन अगर वो एक्सपर्ट, सपोज डॉक्टर है, वो आपको सर्व कर रहा है, उसके पास कुछ ना कुछ वैल्यू होनी चाहिए, ओनली देन ही कैन सर्व यू प्रॉपरली. तो डॉक्टर भी सर्व ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फैक्ट्स एंड वैल्यूज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं बहुत बीमार हूँ, तभी डॉक्टर बोला सब सही हो जाएगा, तो डिस्पाइट द फैक्ट्स ही इज ट्राइंग टू इनकरेज मी, ट्राइंग टू मोटिवेट मी. पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हु विल एडमिनिस्टर द पीपल हु आर रिलेटिवली मैच्योर. सो पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन नथिंग बट सर्विस टू द सोसाइटी बट विद द लेवल ऑफ मेच्योरिटी. So we are not all mature equally. So we are guided by legislative, executive and judiciary. All three are called government. So public administration hota hai to satisfy the public interest. The government going to serve the public interest. Will it be possible without public support? It is not possible without support of public. So government is needed. We need public participation. So first is government. Second one is public participation. So whoever in the public administration should know about the past, present and future. So respect past, solve today and anticipate the future. So public administration should be dynamic. Can he afford to ignore the past? So history we cannot erase. So public administration should be flexible, dynamic, should be innovative. So administration not only think about the past but also future. Innovation, anticipation, creation. Must be integral part of administration. Otherwise administration will not be prepared to prepare yourself for the future requirement. Public administration has to go for the future approach for the based on the experience of the past. So what is public administration? So what is public administration? It is a government administration to ensure the level of maturity in the system to serve the public interest with collective and cooperative approach. Okay, people ko bhi, it won't be possible without people participation with collective and cooperative approach. And administration should be mature enough to know about the past and can deal with the present efficiently and predict the future. So public administration should be dynamic, creative, innovative and anticipated. Administration have to be innovative, anticipated, proactive. So well, aap bhi impacted ho kisi suppose flood se aur log bhi impacted hai, to aap log ke paas aake help karna chahiye, because public administration administrator should consider himself as an integral part of the system. Well, writer answer in a good way or not will not depend on a pen but depend on a hand, because hand is an integral part of your body and will not be sensitive. Despite criticism, public administration required to serve the society. हाथ का criticism हो जाएगा, जल्दी चल नहीं रहा, तभी हाथ पे लिखता रहेगा. So despite criticism, it has to serve the society. Public administration is an integral part of the society. From 1947 to 1990, we have a public administration. So public administration are more or less welfaristic nature. So everything was economy was guided by the government. So public administration. Was guided by state. Welfareism, if we talk about the public administration, was guided by the state. So we have state guided economy, state guided development. So after 1980s we find state guided development not very lucrative. So government consisted of legislative, executive, judiciary, and catering the needs of such a large population wouldn't be possible only with the help of the government. So people are more concerned with the value than the facts. For example, people are more concerned with the freebies, subsidies. So should I, suppose he is a person, should I give him subsidy or should I improve his ability to get the service? I should improve his ability to get the service. The subsidy should be given, but it should be time bound support. So subsidy should be given like to टू प्लांट एंड नर्सरी. तो सब्सिडी शुड बी गिवन लाइक अ सपोर्ट टू प्लांट एंड नर्सरी. तो प्लांट एंड नर्सरी लाइक गिवन टू लाइक अ सपोर्ट टू प्लांट एंड नर्सरी. टू प्लांट अ बनियन ट्री यू कैन नॉट, यू हैव टू कम आउट इन द सन. सो वन डे यू मस्ट हैव टू स्टॉप द सब्सिडीज. सो प्लांट एंड नर्सरी विल नेवर बी अ बनियन ट्री. सो इफ हैज टू बिकम अ बनियन ट्री एंड इट हैज टू कम आउट इन सन इन ओपन, यू विल हैव टू कम अंडर द सन. इफ यू वॉन्ट द नर्सरी वॉन्ट द प्लांट इन द नर्सरी वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ बनियन ट्री. So one day, the day must come to stop welfareism and subsidy. The system will be supportive, not to support, but to grow you from within. The subsidy should be given, but as a means to empower people. 1990s tak welfare tha, now empowerment. After 1900 to 2000, 2020s. So pehle welfareism tha, fir empowerment. Now, after 2000 is self-empowerment. For example, self-help group. Nobody will help, they help themselves. After 1980s. There was a huge strain in the public money. So for how long will continue the policy of welfareism? So IMF, they were denying support to the country who were, especially the third world country, who were victim of welfareism. So hum kya karenge? World Bank, IMF se paisa lenge aur subsidy ki form mein de denge. To kya hum return kar payenge? So isliye public administration is now called new public management. So it is now called new public management. In new public management, emphasis is on market-led development. So in new public management, emphasis is on market-led development. So we are moving from state towards the market due to pressure of the World Bank, IMF, and also collapse of the Soviet Union. So public administration came up with a new problem, that is state versus market. State versus market is also creating problem, though we'll have to think in another way, that is state and market. So we'll come to public-private partnership. The public-private partnership. So we realize the importance of public and private. The issue of the governance came. So issue of governance we find in 1989. The word governance came into picture when World Bank gave call for crisis to sustainable growth. In modern world, issue of the governance came in the 1989. But issue of the governance in modern world, that's a whole, as an older civilization, governance had there. But in modern term, governance came into picture in 1989. But World Bank gave emphasis on government governance. Kisne emphasis kiya? World Bank ne. Government gave emphasis on governance. In the case of Sub-Sahara region, for Sub-Sahara region, from crisis towards sustainable development. From crisis towards sustainable growth. So the title of the report, From Crisis Towards Sustainable Growth. From Crisis Towards Sustainable Growth. On the basis of the survey conducted in Sub-Saharan Africa, World Bank gave the report, From Crisis to Sustainable Growth. So we'll discuss the term governance, good governance and ethical governance. So public administration should be flexible, not rigid. Objective should be realized. Methods may be different, but objective must be realized. So therefore, public administration should be flexible, not rigid. So adaptation is not possible if public administration is rigid. Today, IAS officers are ki past wala, 90s ke jawane wala. It depends on the person. The demand is different, the approach is different. So with time, we have to evolve. So we'll see three topics, governance, good governance, and ethical governance. So what is the difference between government and governance? So yeah, government, for example, okay? We won't talk about the government, we talk about the behavioral aspect of the government, or say what the governance. The government policies, all the word used, the governance used. The behavior aspect of the government is governance. Behavioral aspect of the government is governance. So with good structure, you may not find good behavior. Structure good, body is chilling, it's necessary to be behavior. So government structure may be good, but governance may be bad. Governance is the behavioral aspect of the government. Government important, behavior important. Behavior important. The behavioral aspect of the government is more important than the government itself. Ho sakta hai, bad structure or good behavior. They want good behavior. Means governance is more important than government. Governance is more important than government. जब भी हम बात करते हैं गवर्नमेंट के बिहेवियर क्या होगा, गवर्नमेंट की बात करते भाई तो हमारा फोकस होगा स्ट्रक्चर पे, लेकिन हम बात करते हैं गवर्नेंस की, फोकस विल बी ऑन बिहेवियर ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. तो गवर्नेंस इज नथिंग बट बिहेवियर डायमेंशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. सो टुडे द होल वर्ल्ड इज कंसर्न अबाउट द बिहेवियर ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट रेदर देन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. इसलिए क्वेश्चन था, डेमोक्रेसी इज नॉट अ गारंटी टू द गुड गवर्नेंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बहुत सारी कंट्री में डेमोक्रेसी, बट बिहेवियर विल फाइंड डिफरेंट. Governance related to the manner in which authority is going to be used.
So governance related to the manner in which authority is to be used. So governance is the manner in which authority is going to be used. This authority will be used for rational utilization of available resources. The authority will be used for rational utilization of available resources. The emphasis will be on rational and available.
utilization of resources. Governance do not give instances on utilization of resources, but rational utilization of resources. Available resources, whatever is available to you, how you are going to use it. Now we'll utilize it for common interest. What is the difference between public interest, common interest? So my interest, your interest. Hum dono ka interest hoga public interest. Common interest, living plus non-living. Dono ka interest, common interest. So will development good if people enjoy the development at the cost of the environment. Governance is a behavioral dynamics of the government. So governance is the rational utilization of available resources for common goal, for common interest. So at home, your mother at home utilize the available resources in rational manner. So expenditure will come down. So when we go for rational utilization of available resources, there will be mother life sensitivity. And government expenditure will go down.
So better utilization of resources, this kind of thinking will come when we focus on the governance aspect. So governance is the manner in which authority can be used for the rational utilization of available resources. Manner in which authority, किस manner में authority use हो जाए की जा रही है for the rational utilization of available resources. How governance will be transferred to good governance and wow, what is good in that? So no one will feel good when something is imposed. जैसे school में जाता था, imposed किया जाता था, we never used to feel good. So हम good देखते हैं on the basis of assessment of governance. जो भी governance है उसका assessment करेंगे. अगर output positive निकालता है then good governance. अगर output negative निकालता है bad governance. So on the assessment of the behavior. So how good will be transferred to good governance when some conditions are satisfied. So transfer from good governance to good governance, first condition is globalization of knowledge. Second is morality in leadership. So globalization in knowledge, morality in leadership. So we need from transformation of good governance to good governance, we need globalization of knowledge, morality in leadership, collective cooperative positive humanistic effort. Fourth one is democratic pluralism. We must go for the globalization of knowledge. So knowledge gives us wisdom, and wisdom gives us capability to know what is right and what is wrong. I must allow every knowledge to come from every corner. So knowledge will give you wisdom, and wisdom gives you ability to understand what is right or wrong. So person is not educated but knowledgeable. For example, aapke father itne zyada educated nahi hoge, bas zyada knowledgeable honge. So I must allow every organ of my body to get knowledge from everywhere. And then I'll get to know what is right or what is wrong. So if I have less knowledge, my decision making capability will be less rational. Suppose iski knowledge kam hai, iski knowledge zyada hai, to iska assessment of taking decision alag hoga. So every country want the good, but good will be based on the knowledge. Suppose isko bhi good pata hai, isko bhi pata hai, but interpretation of knowledge will be different, to assessment will be different. So self regulatory mechanism hone chahiye. For example, teacher padhayega ki nahi padhayega, to paise mil rahe hain. तो आई शुड रेगुलेट माई सेल्फ. तो सेल्फ रेगुलेटिंग मैकेनिज्म होना चाहिए. सेल्फ रेगुलेटिंग मैकेनिज्म. इफ नो बडी सीइंग मी, गॉड इज सीइंग मी. इफ गॉड इज नॉट ऑल्सो सीइंग मी, आई हैव टू सी माई सेल्फ. लीडर शुड बी मॉरल, सो पीपल विल ट्रस्ट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई टेल लाई, हाउ कैन आई एक्सपेक्ट यू टू बी ट्रूथफुल. इफ आई कम लेट, हाउ कैन आई एक्सपेक्ट यू टू बी कम ऑन टाइम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आप लड़ाई करके आते हो तो आपके मदर फादर क्या बोलते हैं, आपको ऐसे बिहेव नहीं करना चाहिए. बिकॉज योर एथिक्स शुड बी हाई. So the civil servant should give this a positive humanistic effort, cooperative collective positive humanistic effort. कि आपको ज़्यादा देना चाहिए. For example, teacher दे रहा है तो student क्या कर रहे हैं, ले रहे हैं, attentive है. तो that will be positive effort. So that will be positive efforts and there should be our result. जैसे CRPF लगाते हैं, RP 144 लगाते हैं section, तो आप क्या करो, crush people कर रहे हो people को. So dominance not to crush people, dominance to create situation to integrate. The problem of the governance that you are not able to create a conducive environment of the people to integrate. So how many months more you will require CRPF, curfew. So father must punishing me because my demands were not mature, it's okay. But every time my father punish me, it is inhuman. And his inability will come out that he is not able to explain whatever he wants to explain. So collective, cooperative, positive, humanistic effort, neither dominance is good. The situation will decide when what to do. So democratic pluralism is based on John Rawls' justice theory. So everyone should give the maximum liberty to satisfy their interest. To satisfy the broader interest of the society, liberty of some can be curtailed. So पहले बहुत उपद्रव है नहीं बता, liberty of that those people can be curtailed for the broader objective of the society. that can be curtailed. So everybody has some interest. But to satisfy the broader interest of the society, to satisfy the broader interest of society, liberty of some can be curtailed.
So democratic pluralism prevail when people like downtrodden are supported.
So win-win situation is ensuring democratic pluralism. For example, इसको 5 रुपए चाहिए, इसको 7 चाहिए, तो उसको दे दिए. तो win-win situation will be ensured in democratic pluralism. So governance will be transformed to good governance. Fourth condition are met. So you allow so many parliament rapists to represent ourselves. It's our mistake. So 2/3 of the population are rapists. How can you expect good behavior from them? So democracy should not be quantitative but qualitative. So there is a concept of true democratic pluralism. It's four things we can transform governance to good governance. So we are in the position to answer what is the difference between governance and good governance. How we can transfer governance to good governance. So these four things. So medicine of the reservation should be given only to those people who are suffering, not to all. Reservation itself is not good or bad, but the continuation of reservation and using it for political gain for unlimited time is bad. So good governance, how to become ethical government, but not only means, but not only end, but means are also ethical. If governance is good, then can be ethical in future. Governance will be ethical, but not only means, but also objective are ethical. Means, not only means, but objective also ethical governance. So nothing is more important in public administration than humanity. Demonetization is good with a good objective, but means was not good. If someone die in the queue, the life of a person is more important than the whole public administration. So nothing is more important than the humanity in public administration.
They appreciate trust, truth, technology and trust, truth, technology and touch. Trust, truth, technology and trust. I'm here to serve you, but I should serve with compassion. So ethical governance will be normative expression of the governance. It's a normative expression of governance. So ethical governance is a normative expression of governance. So in this ethical governance, one is try to maximize his own standard of morality. You must be empathetic. The same problem happens to you, how uncomfortable will be you. For example, tribal area mein ja rahe ho, where people come and abuse you. You don't have to lose your calm. You have to be patient. The question puchh chuka hai, governance, good governance and ethical governance. What is the difference between them?